Welcome to the Managing Access to CERS video. This video is part of a series of microlearning style videos from the Introduction to the California Educator Reporting System, or CERS, for test coordinators and administrators. A resource guide accompanies this video series and can be accessed in the description of this video. A TOMS account is required to enter CERS. However, viewing data at the teacher level require students to be rostered through the Managing Student Groups process, also called rostering. That will be covered in the Creating and Managing Student Groups in CERS video. How user accounts are set up will vary from district to district, as assigning TOMS roles is a local decision. It is recommended to use whatever process your district or site already has in place. Please note that access should only be provided to staff who need it. CERS provides access to student information, which must be protected in accordance with federal and state privacy laws, including the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act. It is also recommended to set up users and TOMS early in each school year so that users can access interim assessment data or be ready for the California Alternate Assessments for Science, both of which can be administered or become available early in the school year. Let's dig into this even more. Each year, the superintendent or charter school administrator designates the local educational agency or LEA coordinator. LEA coordinators will then set up site coordinators and TOMS. From there, it is a local decision as to who will set up test administrators, test examiners, and other roles in TOMS. Let's start by understanding what access each role carries in CERS. Coordinators and administrators have a key role in allowing access to others. As you're thinking through the roles assigned, please take into consideration the level of access needed and student confidentiality. TOMS users with the LEA coordinator or educator district role will see all students in the LEA. TOMS users with site coordinator or educator site role will see all students at the site. Please note that the educator roles will not have access to administer any assessments or have access to any of the secure materials like the DFAs or interim assessment hand scoring materials in TOMS. Also, these roles will not see student results grouped by teacher or class unless groups have been assigned to them. TOMS users with a test administrator, test examiner, IA administrator only, or educator roster roles will only see students who are assigned to them through the managed student groups process. If no students are assigned to them, they can log into CERS, but they won't see any results. The CERS User Guide, User Roles and Permissions section has more information. That link is in your resource guide. Another consideration is which role to assign to any roles requiring rostering, meaning test administrators or TA, test examiner or TE, or IA only. Now, one quick note is that the ELPAC also has a TE role, and on the ELPAC side, the TE can administer the ELPAC or the alternate ELPAC. When we talk about TA versus TE, we're talking specifically about the CAASPP. Test examiners administer the California Alternate Assessments, while test administrators administer the general assessments. First, it is recommended that the teachers who will need the test examiner role are identified early in the year. TEs will need to be set up early in the year in order to administer the CAA for Science, which has a window that opens in September. Next, consider the TOMS roles that will be needed during the year. If administering interim assessments, consider assigning the IA administrator-only role to any teachers who plan to administer the interims to start the year. This role allows users to administer interim assessments, but not summative assessments. The IA-only role could be turned into a TA role later in the year once training for the summative test is completed and the test window is approaching. Lastly, consider any local processes for removing active users when they leave the LEA or change school sites. Planning for these items during the setup process will make changes easier throughout the year. A common question about groups is, Can coordinators and administrators or other non-teacher level staff view results for student groups? And the answer is yes, if the groups are also assigned to them. When the coordinator or administrator creates the groups, they can assign any person with any TOMS role to the groups. Thank you for watching the Managing Access to CERS video. We hope you found the information to be useful. The full video series title list is located in the description of this video.